factory class, 5 laps for a total of 64 miles. In today's race, we'll be covering the first start, which will include the Super Open, the Offshore D, and the Offshore C. Now, there's Gifford Racing and Rolling Thunder. Some of the other boats there getting ready. Budweiser and Shooters. There's Gifford Racing there on the inside. There's Rolling Thunder and Budweiser. Almost ready. There's How Sweet It Is, Dirty Laundry, and Budweiser. With Shooters coming up quickly. There's a view of the pack, and there's Gifford Racing with Dirty Laundry. The outside, all jockeying for position, getting ready for that green flag. A closer view of Gifford Marine. Dirty Laundry on the outside. And there's the green flag of the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix has begun. There's Dirty Laundry on the outside in the lead, followed by Gifford Racing. Right behind is How Sweet It Is. Budweiser and Shooters making its way through the pack. Now there's Gifford Marine on the inside, Budweiser on the outside. Dirty Laundry is out of frame and first overall right now. And there's Shooters making its way in the middle, challenging Budweiser and Gifford Marine. Gifford Marine is a 40-foot Jaguar with a white hull powered by two 850 horsepower inboards with number 6 Mercury drives. Bill Gifford is driving at the throttle, Rich Danzigian looking at the Gifford Marine racing team. Some of the other crew members include Steve Solagi, Jerry Balavine, Joe Halbrunner, Mike Burke, and Sue Gifford. The Gifford racing team, like its sponsors Bell Atlantic and Sunoco Racing Fuels, and also the Mercury Marine crew at the Montauk Yacht Base for all their help during this race. You're looking at the Gifford Marine Racing Team. We'd like to wish the Gifford Racing Team the very best of luck in this first national race of the U.S. Offshore for 1993. As we look at Gifford Marine, there is Shooters on the outside, and then right in front is Budweiser. You're now looking at the picture of the onboard camera onboard Shooters Waterfront Cafe. That's freeze frame video's onboard camera. Get a pilot's view of what this race is all about. The green flag is down now, and you see Shooters passing up Widsend Racing from the left side of the picture. You see Widsend Racing, and slowly Shooters is making some headway there, passing up Widsend. And as we keep looking at the picture, looking at the waters, coming into view will be How Sweet It Is. And there is How Sweet It Is. Sure is now passing up How Sweet It Is and looking at some open water. Onboard Shooters driving is Anthony Izzo from Johnstown, Rhode Island, and throttle Rick County from Adventure Farm. Now there are Shooters on the turn. And in front of Shooters is Budweiser. Now they make that turn. Shooters is making up some ground on Budweiser, and they're sort of like neck and neck. And Shooters now has passed Budweiser. Shooters is a 35-foot Jaguar, and Budweiser is a 40-foot skater. Both are pretty close there in the open class, but Shooters taking the lead by a little bit, followed by Budweiser. Shooters, once again, at the 35-foot Jaguar, powered by two 900 horsepower United engines with Mercruiser drives. Ford Anthony Izzo is driving at the throttle, Rick Conti from Adventure Park. Once again, you're looking at how close these two boats really are. There are Shooters on the inside, Budweiser on the outside. Okay, as far as Shooters is concerned, their sponsors are Shooters Waterfront Cafe, and also Molson Beer. The boat has been rigged and maintained by TNT Rigging in Miami, and their engines by Chuck from United Racing Engines in Miami. This is their first race, by the way, in 1993. I'd like to thank the entire crew of Leg X for dialing in Shooters Waterfront Cafe. Currently number one in the open class. You're looking at the Shooters Waterfront Cafe racing team. They're the Shooters Waterfront Cafe racing team, currently first in open class. You can see it's pretty gray out there. The weather is pretty nasty. It's cloudy and raining. Now it looks like that Shooters is pulling away from the helicopter. It shows how fast these boats are really going today. We're having a hard time keeping up with them. Great race here at the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. There is Dirty Laundry. Dirty Laundry is a 46-foot coupe cat, powered by four 900-horsepower Keith Eichert inboards. And to look at Dirty Laundry, we go inside Shooter, where we have our onboard camera giving you a nice view of what the driver sees. As we look at the waters, we see the back of Dirty Laundry. On the left side there, as the picture gets a little bit closer, Dirty Laundry is getting closer, and Shooter's making some headway passing Dirty Laundry. Looks like now that Shooters is number one overall, and Dirty Laundry has been passed. As we look at Shooters, we see Anthony Izzo driving, and at the throttle is Rick Conti from Aventura, Florida. Shooters is now number one overall in this 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. There's Dirty Laundry, driven by Joe Mock from St. Louis, Missouri, at the throttle Harold Smith, or Smitty, as he is affectionately known. He's from Palm Coast, Florida. Dirty Laundry came in first place in San Diego, and also in first place in Long Beach, California, earlier this year. There you see Shooters currently first in open class, and there's Dirty Laundry putting down the hammer and makes a move and picking up some ground. Dirty Laundry, currently first in the superboat class. As you can see, the weather conditions are somewhat deteriorating here as some of the raindrops get on our lens. And there's Dirty Laundry. Apparently, there was some confusion a little bit earlier as to where the turns might be. That's why Dirty Laundry is pulling back. Now, picking up speed, currently number one overall here at the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. Dirty Laundry Racing Team. There you see Shooters on the outside, currently number one in open class. There's C18 Whitsand Racing. It's a 32-foot skater powered by two 580-horsepower Chevy engines with Merc Cruiser drives. On board, driver Robert Witko of Albany, New York. At the throttle, Jim DeNuyer. The Whitsand Racing Team would like to thank Performance Marine of Lake George, New York, for maintaining the Whitsand boat. Currently, Whitsand is number one in C-Class. By the way, this is the first race for the 1993 season for the Whitsand Racing Team. Some of the other competitors in C-Class include Rolling Thunder, Mr. Goodwrench, Foster's Blue Thunder, and how sweet it is, too. That's the Whitsand Racing Team, currently number one in C-Class. As we look back, there's How Sweet It Is, Too, making some headway. Getting a little closer there to Whitsand Racing, so it looks like there's a duel there between Whitsand Racing and How Sweet It Is 2. back again. You see how sweet it is, too, making up some room. Of course, there's still plenty of time in this race. And there's a fight there between first and second place in sequence. You're looking at the Wits End Racing Team here at the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. Currently second in the modified class is How Sweet It Is 2. How Sweet It Is 2 is a 32-foot skater with two 600-horsepower MRD inboards and Merc Cruiser outdrives. Aboard How Sweet It Is 2 is Carlton Myers from Canada's New York and Throttle Jim McIntyre from East Yaphank, New York. Now, as we look at How Sweet It Is 2, which is currently in second place, we see Wits End Racing in first place. Now, it looks like this is going to be a hard race here in the modified division between How Sweet It Is 2 and Wits End Racing. Now, How Sweet It Is 2 is rigged and maintained by MRD in Eastern Long Island, a short way from here, as a matter of fact. How Sweet It Is 2 came in first place in Long Beach, California, and first place in San Diego, California, earlier this year. Now, as you can see, the raindrops in our lens, you can see that it's raining out there, but the conditions are pretty good, actually, for a very fast race because the waters are calm. There's a look now from inside How Sweet It Is 2 with our onboard camera. There you see Carl Myers doing an excellent job driving How Sweet It Is 2. And at the throttle is Jim McIntyre. He's from East Yaphank, Long Island, a short distance away from here. Once again, How Sweet It Is 2 is written and maintained by MRD, also from Eastern Long Island. Driver's point of view in this 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. Some of the other competitors in the modified class, along with How Sweet It Is 2, include Wits End Racing, Mr. Goodwrench, Foster's Blue Thunder, and Rolling Thunder. Once again, you're looking at our onboard camera onboard How Sweet It Is 2. You're looking at the How Sweet It Is 2 racing team. We wish them the very best of luck for the 1993 season. There's Wits End Racing in first place, and it looks like a pretty good fight there between Wits End Racing and How Sweet It Is 2, making some room. Looks like How Sweet It Is 2 is moving up to Wits End Racing. Now, while it's still pretty early in the race, we feel that because these two boats, How Sweet It Is 2 and Wits End Racing, are pretty identical, this race for first place in C class is going to go right down to the wire. There's Wits End Racing, currently in first place, right behind How Sweet It Is 2. Once again, there is our inboard camera, and there's Wits End Racing on the right side there. You can see the driver's view of Wits End Racing as it's making up some ground. Carl Myers doing an excellent job keeping that boat in control. How Sweet It Is 2, keeping it steady on course, right behind Wits End Racing. We wish the How Sweet It Is 2 racing team the very best of luck for the 1993 season. Once again, this is the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. the third U.S. offshore race for 1993 and the first national race for U.S. offshore here in Montauk, Long Island. There's an overhead view of how sweet it is, too. There's D1 Eastern Express. Eastern Express is a 32-foot skater with a white hull and deck powered by two 650-horsepower engines, Chevy engines with Merck Cruiser drive. Aboard Eastern Express, Joseph Bresciami of St. Clair, Michigan. He's driving. At the throttle, Robert Herrig, also from St. Clair, Michigan. Eastern Express took first place in Lake Peoria, Illinois earlier this year. Took that race with an average speed of 112.79 miles per hour. Eastern Express in 1992, well, it was the world champion in its class. And that racing team also were the runner-ups in 1991 in the World Championships. Also the runners-up in 1991 for the national points, and they took third place in 1989 for national points. You're looking at the Eastern Express racing team. Some of the other competition in D-Class, along with Eastern Express, Instant Therapy, Extractor, and Mohegan Warrior. There's Extractor on the inside. Extractor is a 32-foot superboat powered by two 650-horsepower Zool racing engines with Merck Cruiser drive. Ford Extractor. Driving is Al Sibeli from Westbury, New York, and the throttle is Jim Lenzowski from Babylon, New York, navigating Bob Gunzo from Westbury. There's Extractor on the inside and Eastern Express on the outside. Both vying there for first place in D-Class. This one looks like Eastern Express has the edge, but pretty close right now. Both are involved in a pretty good battle there in D-Class. On the inside, Eastern Express on the outside. Both giving each other a pretty good fight. Eastern Express. We wish the Extractor and the Eastern Express racing team the very best of luck for the remainder of this 1993 season during the U.S. Offshore Racing Association campaign. The Extractor, Eastern Express, involved in the duel. D-Class. Well, it looks like the Extractor picked up a little bit on that turn and is now in first place, but this race is certainly not over yet. Eastern Express in second place for the time being. Holding its own, getting closer to Extractor. Good fight in D-Class. There is Ocean Outboard in open class. Ocean Outboard is a 40-foot skater powered by Merck Cruiser 800-plus offshore motors with Merck Cruiser drives. Ocean Outboard is owned by Ernie Deladon from Wilmington, Delaware. At the throttle is Tony Caligiuri from Merck, New York, and driving is Russ Wilkins. Tony would like to thank Ernie Deladon, the owner, for allowing him to run the boat today, since Ernie was not able to be here today. And Tony would also like to thank Mercury Marine. We're looking at the Ocean Outboard Racing Team. Now, some of the other competition in the open class include Team Jaguar, Gifford Racing, Shooter's Waterfront Cafe, Lavat, and Budweiser. That's the Ocean Outboard Racing Team. Throttle man Tony Caligiuri is the owner and operator of Ocean Outboard in Merrick, New York, which is a rigger of high-performance boats. Ocean Outboard is also a dealer for skaters, fountains, superboats, Mercury, and Mercury high-performance products. You're looking at the Ocean Outboard Racing Team. Once again, this is the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. The first national race for U.S. Offshore Racing Association. Currently, we're on S39. How sweet it is. A brand new 28-foot skater powered by two 2.5 EFI Mercury outboards. Driving how sweet it is, Jaron LaChance from Plainville, Massachusetts. And Carlo Terry Harris from St. Charles, Missouri. The owner of How Sweet It Is, Carl Myers from Springfield, New York. How Sweet It Is took first place in Lake Peoria, Illinois earlier this year, but with their older 24-foot skater. Now, of course, there's a brand new 28-foot skater. And this new boat is rigged and maintained by Ocean Outboards. Some of the other competition in the Super Stock class, Hot and Nasty, DeSantis Chevy, and Topaz. Looking at the How Sweet It Is racing team, brand new 28-foot skater. Terriers at the throttle from St. Charles, Missouri, and he's doing a fine job there at throttle. Jaron LaChance, Plainville, Massachusetts. Excellent driving. How sweet it is. Those two 2.5 EFIs sound excellent. And the boat has a good attitude. It's the best of luck. The How Sweet It Is racing team for the rest of the 1993 season. Currently in first place in the Super Stock class, DeSantis Chevrolet, 28-foot skater with a white hull and deck, powered by two 2.5 Mercury outboards. Driving DeSantis Chevy, Daniel DeSantis from West Bridgewater, Massachusetts. And the throttle, Mark Hilsinger from Methuen, Massachusetts. The owner of DeSantis Chevy is DeSantis Chevrolet. The DeSantis Chevy racing team would like to thank some of their sponsors, which include Auto Palace, Sunoco Motor Oil, and Extreme Sportswear. I'd also like to thank Tony, Jim, and Ed at Ocean Outboard for maintaining and rigging the boat, their advice and support as well. One of the other crew members for DeSantis Chevy include Richard DeSantis from Delray Beach, Florida. Once again, DeSantis Chevy is currently in first place in Super Stock. Some of the other competitors in the Super Stock class include Hot and Nasty, Topaz, and How Sweet It Is. Looking at the DeSantis Chevy racing team. There's the 40-foot Jaguar Gifford Racing. As we look at the boat, we can to tell that the Gifford Racing crew did a fine job as Gifford Racing is smoking around that course, making up some ground. Boat has a real good attitude. As it goes by the first boat in S-Class, DeSantis Chevy. That's the Gifford Racing team. There's the 28-foot Manta, the Fever. And let's tell you that the Fever is back because the Fever right now is number one in B-Class. As you may know, this boat has a tremendous race history, has been retired for a while, but now is back into the competition and giving everyone a lot of competition. Currently number one in B-Class. And if it continues to run the way it's running right now, well, there's no way that the other boat's going to catch up. On board, Joe Sproul from Belmore, New York. He's the driver. At the throttle, Joe Latona from Merrick, New York. Navigating, Jeff Cropper from Dix Hills, New York. The Fever Racing Team would like to thank the S&S Propeller Company, Rich Zuhl for the motors. And by the way, those Zuhl motors are sounding terrific. And They'd also like to thank Al Grover Marine in Freeport, Long Island. They're looking at the Fever Racing Team, currently number one in B class. Some of the other competition in B class include Burning Desire, Rip and Tear, Instigator, Shockwave, and Parts Plus, and we're all having a hard time catching up to Fever. Fever currently number one in B class. This is the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix, the first national race for the U.S. Offshore Racing Association. There's P-85 Jaws, a 32-foot superboat, white and red hull and deck, powered by three 2.5 Mercury outboards. On board Jaws, driver Ronnie Appleby from Denville, New Jersey, at the throttle of David Horseman from Hackettstown, New Jersey, navigating John Stalling from Hanover, New Jersey. Some of the sponsors of Jaws include Cody Marine, Solidi Auto Parts, and Florham Park Transmissions. Jaws took second place in 1992 in the Nationals and also second place in 1992 in the Regionals. Some of the other crew members include Pat DeFalco from East Hanover, New Jersey, and Barry Cupoli from Johnsburg, New Jersey. You're looking at the Jaws Racing Team. Some of the other competitors in the Pro Stock class, along with Jaws, High Risk, Great Adventure, and Insanity. This 32-foot superboat is manufactured right here on Long Island by Superboats in Lindenhurst, Long Island. A brand new boat for this racing team, the Jaws Racing Team. We wish Jaws the very best of luck for the 1993 racing season. Currently number two in the Pro Stock class. There's Shockwave, a 32-foot Hustler powered by two 600-horsepower Bandit racing engines and Merc Cruiser drives. Shockwave is manufactured by Hustler Powerboats in Hampton Bays, Long Island. On board Shockwave is driver Rick Tropoli from Towns River, New Jersey, navigating Tom Pato from Big Town, New Jersey. And at the throttle, Mike Fiore from Hampton Bays, Long Island. Mike's dad, Paul, is the owner of Hustler Powerboats in Hampton Bays. Shockwave Racing Team would like to thank Paul Fiore, as well as Kurt Berger from Kurt's Marine. Currently, Shockwave is running second behind Fever in the sport class, and we at Freeze Frame Video would like to wish the Shockwave Racing Team the very best of luck for the remainder of the 1993 U.S. Offshore Racing Season. The entire Shockwave Racing Team is doing a fine job. Rick Tropoli is Tom's River driving, Mike Fiore at the throttle, and Tom Pato navigating, all doing a fine job. Currently number two in the sport class, the Shockwave Racing Team. There you see some of the rain on our lens, but the competition is just terrific right now in Montauk here, the U.S. Offshore Race. The waters are calm, making it for very fast racing. Mr. Goodwrench currently running third in C-Class. Mr. Goodwrench is a 28-foot challenger with a black, red, white hull and deck, powered by two 750-horsepower Chevy motors and Mercury drives. Aboard Mr. Goodwrench, driving and throttling, Mr. Jim Agle from Peoria, Illinois. Navigating, Jim DeBoard, also of Peoria. The Mr. Goodwrench racing team would like to thank some of its sponsors, which include Chevrolet More Power, GM Parts, and Challenger. Mr. Goodwrench was the 1992 champion in the Central Division. Some of the other crew members include Sean Bowens, Mike Bowens, Joe Maxwell, Dick Ash, and Dwayne Parker. You're looking at the Mr. Goodwrench racing team. Some of the other competition in C-Class, along with Mr. Goodwrench, Rolling Thunder, Foster's Blue Thunder, Wits End, and How Sweet It Is Too. Once again, Mr. Goodwrench is currently running third in C-Class. Mr. Goodwrench is a brand new boat, and by the looks of it, it has a great attitude. The engines are running fine. It just looks terrific. Doing a fine job here with the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix. Earlier this year, Mr. Goodwrench took second place in Lake Peoria, Illinois. We're looking at the Mr. Goodwrench racing team. There's Team Jaguar passing by in second place in open class. Here's an update on how those boats are doing in open class. As we said, Team Jaguar is in second. In first place is Ocean Outboard. In third place is Gifford Racing. Shooter's Waterfront is fourth. And Labatt and Budweiser are out of the competition in open class. In Offshore D, it's Eastern Express and Instant Therapy. Mohegan Warrior is out of the race. In the modified class, it's How Sweet It Is Too, Rich Sand and Mr. Goodwrench. Rolling Thunder is retired from the race in that class. In Pro Stock is High Risk and Jaws. Now you're looking at Hot and Nasty in the Super Stock class. Hot and Nasty is S3, a 30-foot Cobra powered by two 2.5 Mercury outboards. The owner-driver is Bill Mock from Setauket, Long Island, at the throttle Richmond City from Ronkonkoma, Long Island. This is the first race for this Hot and Nasty racing team, brand new boat. Some of the sponsors include Lexington Fire Protection, CNJ Auto Collision of East Setauket, Long Island, WHM Plumbing, and Cody Marine. The Hot and Nasty racing team would also like to thank Pete from Cobra and Doug from Pro Marine. And of course, the boat is maintained by Brandon Kuhn. You're looking at the Hot and Nasty racing team currently running number two in the Super Stock class. Some of the other competitors in the Super Stock class include Topaz, How Sweet It Is, and DeSantis Chevy. You're looking at the Hot and Nasty racing team. Once again, this is the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix and the first national race for the United States Offshore Racing Association. As we look at the Hot and Nasty racing team, we'd just like to say that the boat looks like it has a great attitude. Both the driver and throttle man are doing a great job. Bill Mock driving and Rich from the city at the throttle. Considering this is their first race and it's a brand new boat, well, they're doing a great job. In the factory class, Ocean Outboard on the inside and Gone Bananas on the outside are fighting it out for first place. Ocean Outboard is a 21-foot challenger, powered by one 2.4 EFI. driver of Ocean Outboard is Tom Rink. At the throttle, Mike Gagliano, both from Seaford, Long Island. And Gone Bananas is a 24-foot banana with red, yellow hull and deck, powered by one Johnson Outboard. The owner of Ocean Outboard is Michael Gagliano from Seaford, New York. Ralph Viano, also of Seaford, New York, is another crew member for Ocean Outboard. The Ocean Outboard racing team would like to thank Tony at Ocean Outboard and the entire crew for all their help. Also, Jim, Ed, and John at Ocean Outboard. You're looking at the Ocean Outboard racing team in the factory class. Now, of course, in the factory class, anyone basically with one engine could enter, and that makes it really available to just about anyone out there. And you can see the competition that's going on right now. Pretty exciting competition between Ocean Outboard and Gone Bananas fighting it out for first place. On board Gone Bananas is Richard Fortunato, the owner and driver. He's from Colchester, Connecticut. At the throttle, William Farber from Coal Valley, Illinois. Some of the other competition in the factory class, along with Gone Bananas, is Hyperactive, Feeling Wet, and Spoiled Banana. It looks like that this race here for first place in factory class is going to go right down to the wire. All these boats in factory class, even though they are of the lowest class, are running still throughout this race, even though some of the more expensive boats in this race have retired because of technical problems. And there you see Gone Bananas and Ocean Outboard fighting it out for first place. In B class, there's Burning Desire, a 30-foot Cobra, brand new boat, constructed this year. The manufacturer of the motor is GM. It's powered by a 1,600-horsepower GM motor and Merc Cruiser drives. The owner-driver is Mr. John Woolley from Manasquan, New Jersey, and the throttle, Greg Young from Brick, New Jersey. Mr. Woolley says that he decided to go with a brand new boat because he says new is definitely better. Once again, this is Burning Desire in Sport Class, or B Class. A lot of competition in B Class. There's also Fever in B Class, which is leading right now, followed by Shockwave, then Rip and Tear, and of course Burning Desire. Other competitors include Instigator and Parts Plus, all in B Class. We're looking at the Burning Desire racing team. Brand new boat seems to be operating very well. Good attitude. The motor sounds excellent. Boat seems to be right on course. And it's the 1993 Monsanto Offshore Grand Prix, the first national race, U.S. Offshore Racing Association. We have pre-screened video. Look forward to seeing Burning Desire the rest of the 1993 season, and we wish them the very best of luck. Currently, running fourth is Burning Desire. In F class, there's Hyperactive. Hyperactive is a 21-foot activator with a blue and white hull and deck, powered by one 2.4 Mercury outboard. Owner driver is Mr. William Scudder from Freeport, Long Island. There's Shooter going by in the open class. At the throttle in Hyperactive is Ronald Rossi, also from Freeport, Long Island. The Hyperactive crew would like to thank Ocean Outboard, Ed Riley and crew, also Little Bill, Kelsey and Cindy. We're looking at the Hyperactive racing team in F class. Some of the other competitors in F class: Feeling Wet, Spoiled Banana, Gone Bananas, and Ocean Outboard. Hyperactive is currently running third in F class. In first is Ocean Outboard, and then second, Gone Bananas. And that race is still being fought for first place there between Ocean Outboard and Gone Bananas. We at Freeze Frame Video believe that this factory class is a great idea. It gets people who own the smaller boats and use them for pleasure to use also them in competition and just see how well they can do. And just a reminder, all the boats in F class are still running. There are 5 boats in F class. They're still running, while some of the more expensive boats in the other categories, well, they've retired for the race. In the meantime, there's a lot of competition going on in F class. Once again, in third place is Hyperactive. Ocean Outboard is in first and Gone Bananas in second. In Sport class, Fever is in first, followed by Shockwave. And in third place is Rip and Tear. In Superstock, DeSanta Chevy and Hot and Nasty. And in the Modified class, How Sweet It Is Too, and Witsand and Mr. Goodwrench in third. The Offshore D, Ethan Express in first. And in the Open class, Ocean Outboard in first, followed by Team Jaguar. Currently in first place in A-Class is RC Marine, a 30-foot superboat with a yellow hull and deck, powered by 2 385-horsepower Zool inboards with Merc Cruiser outdrives. On board RC Marine, driver Steve Abbott from Laurel Hollow, New York. At the throttle is RC from West Islip, New York. Navigating is Steve Sokolich from Astoria, New York. RC, the owner of RC Marine, would like to thank the Surf Club of Montauk, Long Island, for some fine accommodations for the race. I'd like to thank Tom for helping out and doing a great job and helping the team in their accommodations. Also, RC would like to thank Rick Silvestri, the chief mechanic, MRD, for all their help and support, and Richie Zuhl for his contributions to the team. Also, Matt Koenig from Amsoil for always being there when needed. And RC says he has a very special thanks to his daughter Melissa for giving him that special incentive all racers need to win. And they are winning. They are currently in first place in A-Class, RC Marine. And now we take you on board RC Marine with our helmet cam, and that camera is being worn by navigator Steve Sokolich from Astoria, New York. There's the view just before the start from RC Marine. And the ride is a little bit bumpy, a little shaky picture, but we thought it was worthwhile to get a real good eye view. And the green flag is down, and RC Marine, and on the left is High Risk from P-Class, shooting out like a bullet, taking the lead. And there's the spray from High Risk. You're looking at what the navigator, Steve Sokolich from Astoria, New York, has seen with our helmet cam. We know the picture's a little rocky, but there's Great Adventure on the right side, RC Marine's nearest competitor. As I was saying, the picture is a little shaky, but we thought it was worthwhile for us to show you because it's a great, exciting inside that cockpit view of what the race looks like, or what it looked like at the very beginning of this race. And as you see there, the water going by at high speeds, and there's Great Adventure again. Great Adventure is currently running second, and in first place is RC Marine, first place in A-Class. Now, Jeff Girardi of Freeze Frame Video would personally like to thank RC for all his help in engineering, machining, and manufacturing all the onboard rigging equipment for the onboard camera for this 1993 U.S. Offshore Racing Association season. Once again, RC Marine is currently in first place in A-Class. Nonetheless, though, it's still a hard-fought race there between RC Marine and Great Adventure, currently in second. This is the 1993 Montauk Offshore Grand Prix in Montauk, Long Island. There's Dirty Laundry going by. He's currently in first place overall. Of course, Dirty Laundry is in the Superboat class, just smoking around that race course, averaging over 100 miles per hour. There's RC Marie on the inside. In second place in A-Class, Great Adventure, a 31-foot Zeppelin, the White Holland Deck, powered by two 450-horsepower professional marine inboards with Mercury drives. Onboard Great Adventure, owner-driver Bill Gazelle of Britton, New Jersey, at the throttle Gary Hartman of Seabright, New Jersey, navigating Warren Gazelle, also of Britton, New Jersey. Great Adventure took third place in Panama City earlier this year. We're looking at Great Adventure currently running second and in A class. Other competitors in A class include Wide Open, Dirty Dancer, Taboo, and of course, RC Marine. Great Adventure looking good. Good attitude, the engine sound real fine. Currently in second place in A-Class. There you see the navigator pointing the driver in the right direction. Looking at Great Adventure. As we draw closer to the end of this 1993 Mazda Dauntless Grand Prix, here are some of the standings in the open class. It looks like Ocean Outboard that is in first place, followed by Team Jaguar, Gifford Racing, and Offshore D. Eastern Express and Instant Therapy. Modified House Suite it is too, followed by Whitsand and Mr. Goodrich. In the Pro Stock, High Risk, followed by Jaws. And in the Super Stock, the Santa Chevy, followed by Hot and Nasty, Topaz, and now Suite it is. In the Production Class, RC Marina's in first place. Great Adventure in second, and Wide Open in third. And we're looking at Great Adventure in A-Class, right now running in second place. That's Hyperactive in the F-Class on the outside, currently running in third place in the Factory Class. Now there is Rip and Tear in B-Class. It's a 31-foot profile with a pink Holland deck, powered by two 525-horsepower Mercury inboards and Speedmaster drives. The driver is Dick Castellini from Vineland, New Jersey. At the throttle is Ed DePalma from Milton, New Jersey. And navigator is Andy Castellini. The owner of Rip and Tear, Atlantic Offshore Boats in Vineland, New Jersey. Currently running in third place, Rip and Tear in sports class. There's Rip and Tear now, veering off to the right, slowing down, approaching the finish line, and it has completed its race, and it's come in third in its class. The Rip and Tear race team. There's Great Adventure, the P5 boat, the 30-foot Cobra, and even though it's down on its power, we thought we'd mention it, that the driver Bill Pfister and throttle man Doug Lewis are on board. We thought we'd mention it because Pro Marine, which rigs and maintains the boat, is changing its name to Professional Marine. And, of course, we have three-frame video wish Professional Marine and Doug Lewis the very best of luck. In just a few moments, we'll be compiling the final results for the 1993 Offshore Grand Prix in Montauk, Long Island.